If you're using NX 3D CAD software and want to find interferences between moving parts or create flashy presentations or assembly instructions, you've come to the right place. I'll teach you how to animate in minutes.
When designing parts that have to fit, sometimes the best place to start is with a 2D free body diagram, especially when the parts are moving. By using simple sketches, it's often easier to find fit and position issues before committing to 3D. Let's check it out.
Let's simulate the steering in this four-wheeled vehicle. My steering is just, as of right now, a free body diagram with just a bunch of dimension sketches. You can see the size of my wheels, wheelbase, distance between the rear wheels, turning radius, and the angle that's going to cause that turning radius to happen. All right, what we want to do is animate this thing. As with every other animation, we're going to create some rigid groups. This will tell the system what can move. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to lock down everything that can't move, like the rear wheels and the rear axle. Then I'm going to make a rigid group out of the front wheel, its steering linkage, and this reference geometry, or just so we can kind of see everything happen as the wheels are turning. Same general process with the other side. One last rigid group should be the steering linkage right across them. All right, now that I've got my rigid groups created, we got to tell the system how it can move. So that's what a joint is all about. So the first thing I'm going to do, as you have seen in previous videos, we're going to lock everything down that can't move. Then I'm going to put a revolute joint between this first wheel and the frame. And we're going to let its pivot point be right around the center of that wheel. Same thing for the opposite side. And I'm just going to simply follow the command prompts and pick the geometry like I'm supposed to be doing. Last revolute joint will be around the steering linkage and that cross member. And one last one on the other side. I think that's going to do it for us. Now I can use my rigid group command to kind of dance things back and forth and get a better visual of if I've done my rigid group creation right. And it looks like everything is sort of moving the way I want it to. So I think I've got everything done. Now it's going to be time to put a motor on here to get things to automatically move back and forth. So we'll just pick any one of these joints, maybe my wheel itself, and we'll let it go 20 degrees because that's what we found earlier. I'm going to add another event to bring it right back by keying in minus 20 degrees. Then we hit the play button. You can see how the steering wheel is going to, or the steering geometry is going to dance back and forth. Now, I do want to put a little bit of a delay in here so I can see this thing a little bit better in the middle before it snaps back. So we're going to drag my event bars out, add a delay, and you can see exactly where it stops, and then it retracts back to its original starting point. Key pieces of information we don't know are what the angles are. So we're going to add a monitor between the these reference geometries for our turning radius. And then we're going to turn a graphing function on and see exactly what everything does. And once that's done, we can use a probe tool and realize that at full turn, we can see what the steering radius is are. And at straight, the angle between the radius is 0.017 and 0.05. Probably good enough for straight line driving, but if we want to tweak that, we can just always manipulate the geometry to get a slightly different answer in there. But that's how you can use Animation Designer to simulate a free body 2D diagram. Once you have all your geometry laid out, then you can make the jump to 3D.
Well, hopefully you're ready to put Animation Designer together for your free body 2D diagram designs. Keep watching and keep inventing.
Well, that covers this week's lesson. If you learned something, give me a thumbs up. If you have a tip to share, leave a comment so my subs can learn more. Thanks for watching.